An animated brush is just a brush file that rotates through multiple brush tips instead of a single brush tip. In order to create an animated brush, first, make a new document and set the size to 1000 by 1000 pixels. This is the largest default size that creator brushes can be. The first thing you want to do is make sure your background layer is transparent. You can do this by hiding the background layer. In an animated brush, every visible layer will become one of the brush tips in your animated brush. Any layers which you've hidden will be left out. Here I've created a bunch of chain links and I've placed each one on a different layer. Make sure that you make your brush tips completely black, as it will give you the most control over transparency and value when we're putting the brush settings together. If you're thinking about using gray or white, I'd recommend going to this timestamp here, where I show you the different combinations of brush tip values and how they interact with the mandatory settings you need to click through to create your brush. Okay, so once you have your brush tips, one per layer like I have here, to then make them into a brush, we need to come up to the Edit Brush Settings button right here. If you don't have the brush tool selected, it won't open the menu, because this is also how you edit the brush that you're currently using. But you can use the F5 keyboard shortcut to force it to open, in which case Krita will just auto-select the last brush you used. Now, these are the settings for the brush that you are currently using. So if you already have your animated brush or an animated brush similar to the one that you're making now with all its settings set up and you just want to edit it a bit, make sure to go to your brush preset Zocker and reselect a brush that has settings that are similar to the one that you want to create. That way you don't have to do everything from scratch. Okay, so now that we've opened the Edit Brush Settings tab, just click on the plus stamp button right here, and if we highlight it, it'll tell us creates a brush stamp from the current image selection. If no selection is present, the whole image will be used. This just means that it'll create a brush tip from the current layer unless we've selected a part of that layer with one of the selection tools, in which case it'll only use what's contained in that selection. This is also how we create regular brush tips too, so you'd just be using a single layer instead of multiple layers like we're using for the animated brush. Once we click it, this new window should pop up. The first thing you need to do is click the drop-down menu next to style. There should be two options, regular and animated. Click it and then click on animated, which will make it so that it uses all visible layers to create the brush. Next you have selection mode. Constant is pretty useless. All it seems to do is just use the image from the topmost layer and repeat it. It's basically a regular brush, and I'm not really sure why it's even an option. Next we have random, which will cycle through the layers randomly when you paint. This is most useful for organic brushes like leaves or grass or something similar, but there's a chance that it'll select the same layer multiple times in a row, which is why it isn't as good for my chain brush, for example, because I could get three links facing the same direction in a row, which wouldn't work because for each link to be connected to each other, they need to be rotated slightly in order to interlock. Our next option is incremental, which starts from the topmost layer and it works its way down one layer at a time before looping back to the first layer. This is what I have my brush set as, and this way I can control the order that the links appear in by the order that I've set the layers as. In this mode, it'll always start from the first layer every time you start drawing. So to get some variety from this, you can simply draw part of the chain, stop before it reaches the end of the loop, and then start drawing again to create different patterns. But since each stroke always starts with the same link, you'll have to be careful when using something like this because it can be easy to spot if you don't work to hide the pattern in some way when you're painting. We then have pressure and angular. Pressure needs a pressure-sensitive tablet to work with because it selects different layers based on how hard you're pressing down with your stylus. And drawing angle chooses a layer based on the direction of your stroke. I'd recommend choosing incremental or random based on whatever brush you're creating. I would also uncheck the auto button next to spacing, and then manually adjust the spacing yourself if you're creating a chain brush or something that needs to link together with precision. Otherwise, Krita will just change the spacing based on the size of the brush, and you'll get spaces in your brush, or they'll become too close together if you make the brush too large or too small. Whether to check Create Mask from Color or Preserve Alpha Channel will depend on what color you drew your brush tips in. I'd recommend experimenting with this on your own time, but I'll still go over all the combinations real quick. Here's the visual I made, which shows the effects of all the combinations with red as my selected color from the color palette here. The color of each brush tips that I made the brush in is dotted in right below each chain, so black, gray, and white. With both unchecked, pure white and pure black maintain their original colors completely. However, gray is mixed with the selected color and it creates more of a neutral red. Because when both are unchecked, it takes value from the brush, but it allows you to choose the color. Black and white stay black and white because you can't have pure black and pure white while also having some color mixed in there. When you select Create Mask from Color, it maps the value of the brush to transparency. Black being completely opaque and white being completely transparent, which is why the white chain isn't here, because it's completely transparent. This makes black the only value that allows you to paint with a full range of transparency. When you check both, it maintains the transparency of the original stamp and maintains the value of the original stamp, meaning that any color you choose will have its value automatically chosen based on the original color of your brush stamp. And if you made any parts of the stamp transparent, it'll also maintain transparency in that area. This is why I recommend making your brush tips pure black with only mask from color selected, because it's the only option that allows you to completely control the color, value, and transparency of your brush. Now back to our animated brush. Once you've checked the options that you want and you click save, our animated brush tip should be loaded in and saved to the predefined tab here. It should also be automatically selected. If not, just search for it using the search bar at the bottom here. Then on the left, we can see all the settings, so size, ratio, spacing, etc. For our chain brush, we want all these unchecked except for rotation, which is down here. We don't want size checked because we don't want the size of the links to change based on our pen pressure. And we don't want opacity either, which is up here, so uncheck the enable pen settings button for this one as well, since this is also linked to pen pressure and we don't want our links to be transparent. Now in the rotation window, there'll be another list of parameters. Keep them all unchecked except for drawing angle, and then set the slope to linear by either clicking the quick slope button up here at the top or by clicking and dragging the circles in either corner. This will encompass the full range of drawing angles that we can achieve, and it also makes it so that Krita will check the direction we're drawing in and rotate the links based on that. Krita checks the drawing angle even when you're not touching the pen to the paper, so you'll find that if you're using this chain brush, for example, and you just click down, it'll kind of have like a random, seemingly random link angle. It'll be different from the other links that your strokes are in, unless you're starting the stroke before you touch the stylus to the tablet. So make sure that you kind of lead it a bit when you use brushes like this. Now, if your links are rotated like 90 degrees or so, which they should be at this point, if you drew them vertically like I did in the original layers, go back to the brush tip parameter at the very top, and then come down here to between where it says size and spacing, and there's an option for rotation. Just type in 90 degrees, which will rotate the stamp 90 degrees by default. If you drew your links at a different angle, then you'll have to figure out how much you need to rotate it for yourself, but that shouldn't be too hard, since you can always just test your brush in the scratch pad over here. Now, once you have everything set the way you want it, make sure you go up here and you click Save New Brush Preset, which will save this as a completely new brush without overwriting any current brush. Once that's done, you'll probably notice that whatever brush you had selected when you first opened the brush menu is probably looking a little bit weird. This is because we edited that brush when we created our new brush tip, but we didn't overwrite that brush, so it's still there. These are all only temporary settings, which Krita does. When you open up the brush menu and you edit things, it'll save those temporarily. So there's two ways we can get rid of that. The first is to click on the original brush again that you had selected when you first opened the brush menu, and then click this button up here that almost looks like the recycling symbol, and it'll reset it to its default values. The second way to fix it is just to close out and reopen Krita, because it'll get rid of all of your temporarily saved data. Lastly, make sure to save the document as a .kra file so that you can go in and edit the brush or create variations of it in the future if you wanted to. If you wanted to create a regular brush, it's the same thing, except you just use one layer and you keep it on regular instead of selecting animated.
If you enjoyed this video and want to see similar videos, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe.